What is up, Darkview Nation? I'm your host, and I'm back for another review. It's gonna be shorter than regular because I'm disclaimer right now. I did not finish this game. I think this was a bad game. I think this was underdeveloped. I think it should have been held for another year and worked on. I don't believe that the actual game developers even played their own game. I don't think they even knew what they made. But nevertheless, I'm looking at the gameplay of the game. I'll look at the presentation and I'll look at the overall impact it had on me. So let's jump right into that.
Well, off I go to a camp of robbers. Maybe I can defeat them with my rapier sharp wit.
Okay, this game sucks straight up. There's no going around it. This was somehow a survival game. I don't know why they added that aspect into here. The stealth was below par. The actual gameplay and missions were some of the worst I've seen in my life. If you want to name me a mission, a main mission that wasn't some sort of something like, hey, B character, side character, I need blank object. Can you run there and come back with it? You could name a mission that wasn't that. Every mission, it's, oh, Sally needs this. I got to go there. Oh, Ollie needs this. I need to go there. Oh, I need this. I got to run there, run back. 95% of this game is sprinting back and forth, which is annoying. Because in this game, if you sprint, everybody wants to kill you. Yeah, if you sprint in this game, in the main cities, you'll literally get targeted by police and everything else. So that is extremely annoying. And it got to the point where I literally didn't even want to play this game because of how bland the mission is. It's like if you take like a bowl of oatmeal and it had no spice, no nothing, it's just literally one oat in the bowl and you ate it. You're like, yep, that was delicious. Like, no joke, this was horrible. And I didn't even finish this game, in fact, because I got to part two, which I didn't think would be part two. And then I realized when I looked up how long is part two, I found out there's a part three. At that point, I went to my PS4 and deleted the game. And you know, that might seem harsh, but I got other stuff to play. I still want to play through Red Dead Redemption. I've heard a lot of good things about that. I've seen gameplay. I think it's right up my alley, and it's a very long game. I gotta get onto that. Darksiders 3, Life is Strange 2. I had Spider-Man is my next game I'm playing. I'm playing through that right now, and I'm loving it. That game was up on my list too. And you know, I don't want to see. I spent 15 hours in the first part because of how, you know, stupid it was. And then all of a sudden, there's a part 2 and a part 3. No, you lost me right there. This game was horrible. There's only one saving grace of this game, for gameplay at least, it's not even talking about presentation, is the main character in the first part was, he was hilarious. I think that was the only part I liked, is when you're just running around. He was very deadpan humor and everything. That's literally the only thing I liked in gameplay of this. There's no hiding around how bad this game was. That's right. Sadly, 11 out of 100. That's one of the lowest scores I've ever got. I think it is a lower score, but pros, good main character, that's it. Cons, repetitive missions, bland gameplay, no effort into it. I literally think that the developers didn't even play this game. I feel like they just put, you know, had a deadline, they put all their time into the aesthetics, and then they dumped it off. I really feel like this game was buggy, it was broken, it was glitched. I had so many glitches. I got bounced off the map like 7 different times. Like, I'm not even kidding you. I mean, I can't believe how many times I've been, you know, screwed over by glitches in this game. It was extremely bland, it was boring, and it was really dumb. So yeah, that's my take on gameplay. Moving on to the presentation. Moving on to your presentation, this is the saving grace of this game. If it wasn't for this, I wouldn't have probably made it into the first, you know, 5 hours. Because honestly, the presentation of this game is awesome. The voice acting was superb from the first, the first guy I played as, Arthur. And, you know, everything was really nice in this game. The sounds, the soundtrack, the look of the game. It really gives off this Bioshock, you know, kind of phase, which seems a little obvious. But, you know, it is really unique. It's... you know, you have to take joy, and if you aren't, you know, happy, then, you know, everyone starts to turn on you. And I think it brings up, you know, even though this is a presentation, this is more for general impact, it brings up a good morale question of, is this a good world to live in for me? Because I was thinking about this, and it brings up a question is, if everyone is happy and they're just, you know, high on joy, everything is good. You know, there's no wars going on in there. There's no nothing that I can see except for, you know, some of the people who, you know, are You know, I just realized this game doesn't even make sense because the guys on the outside who aren't in the main city are like scraggling out old clothes and then they're just not accepted. So even on Joy, there is still like the discriminatory things going on. Like literally, this game is horrible. I'm thinking about it. This game makes no sense. I don't know. Maybe I'm just tripping right now, but presentation, everything looks really nice in this game. As far as I can tell, I didn't get to the second or third part, but just, God, this game's so bad. Coming in at a solid 79 out of 100. Pros, really unique. A good soundtrack, good main voice acting, a great killer cons. I don't really see that many cons, or none at all, in fact, for the presentation. It was a very, very solid presentation. I think they really thought it out, unlike the gameplay. But moving on to general impact.
Don't you look wonderful? Please proceed to the next room in case
So coming into the overall, you know, general impact, I can't really say a lot because I never finished the game. I only finished a third of the game, technically speaking, according to the parts, but I only finished part one. I got an hour into part two, quit, deleted the game. I don't really want to speak too highly of it, so don't take this all in my opinion, but this game was horrible. Am I missing something? If I am, if maybe part 2 and 3 were insane, comment down below if it, you know, got better. But there is one thing I remember from this game. It's the funniest gaming moment of, you know, the whole year for me. Is this was a great moment in the game, is when you are taking the quiz so you can go into the next district or whatever. But you have to pass this quiz, right? And you have to guess the answers right. And every single time, there was, you know, a normal answer, and then there was an answer that could be right, and then there's another answer that was literally like the eyes. Like, no matter what, it was the eyes, and I was literally cracking up over that. And to top it all off, this is literally so great. In the end, there's a question that says, what happens if you take too much joy? And, you know, if you listen to the pre-package, you know, clip, you'll obviously guess, you know, can't find your way home because, it, you know, memory loss. There's also an answer that is, who cares? You know, too much joy, I don't care, I always take joy. And this one is, you know, the eyes, the eyes. And the correct answer is, I can't find my way home. But they're like, that was a trick question. Although you will not be able to find your way home, who cares if you take too much joy? Like, I literally could not believe my eyes. This is a quick minute of, you know, stuff that went on. This was so great.
Lionel Cashier, glad he's still around.
If you want to fit in, you should. A, say hello to everyone you meet, like how you do. B, visit people's houses, whether they're there or not. C, the eyes, the eyes.
What is with the eyes? Why eyes?
That's right, player one. Jack Constable. Constable Constable, your question.
Right, well, here's my interrogative. If I see you running, jumping about, or crouching in the shadows, what will I likely do? A, tell you to stop your rotten shenanigans before I smash you in the face. B, run and jump and play myself. C, oh God, the eyes.
What is with the eyes? Every answer. Oh God, the eyes.
Your question, please.
If you want to make friends with me, should you A, give me flowers, B, talk about old times, C, stop staring at me, why is everything staring?
When you take too much joy, A, you can't find your own house, B, who cares, C, please God, make them stop staring.
I'm afraid that was a bit of a trick question. It's true, you can't find your house when you overdose on joy. But we want you to see the broader truth, which is, who cares? Oh, player two, today
what
a ripoff!
What?
But
what?
You can always come back.
Flying in at 20 out of 100 for overall impact. Pros, good idea for the game. didn't really work out. Unique, main character was good, I really liked him. Cons, horribly bland, insanely repetitive, unbelievable. I mean, this game had so much potential. I think if it was in the right hands, it could have been really something good. And overall score for the game, 3.4 to 10. Don't take this fully, take it with a grain of salt, just because I didn't play the full game. Maybe I am missing out on something crazy, but as of right now, 3.4 out of 10 is a horrible score for a game, and I think it deserves it. But for now, I will leave you with me dumping a guy inside the vent and making his legs go up. And I'll be playing Spider-Man in the background, a game that I'm really enjoying so far, a couple hours in. So, peace, see you all next time. Sticking until the end, you are a true MVP. Like and comment down below. I really do want to hear the opinion of the people who watch this video and whatnot. And make sure to subscribe, because there's going to be always more content I'm putting out, always more videos, always more game reviews. Hopefully you enjoy. Peace.